Small self-contained sprayers represent a simple and accurate way to apply liquid herbicides, fertilizers, fungicides, insecticides, and plant growth regulators. Ewing offers many options, including the 2-gallon pump hand cans and 4-gallon pump backpacks, as well as battery-powered versions of each. Like any tool, the better you understand how to use and maintain your sprayer, the better your results will be. Proper sprayer calibration and operating pressure are essential, but just as critical is selecting the right nozzle for the job. Nozzles, often referred to as sprayer tips, come in a wide variety of styles, angles, or patterns, and output volume or flow rate. Choosing the correct nozzle ensures you meet label requirements for application rate while maximizing performance and minimizing waste. In this video, we'll focus on the most common nozzles that come with sprayers, like the EMPRO and Ewing brand sprayers. These include an adjustable brass nozzle, flat fan, jet stream, and foaming nozzles. Nozzle selection affects 4 key things: the amount of chemical applied, the uniformity of application, how well it covers the target surface, and potential drift. It's also important to know how the chemical needs to be applied when selecting a spray nozzle. Does it need to reach the soil, or is it a contact or systemic foliar treatment that needs to stick to the plant to be effective? Contact treatments remain on the surface of the plant and kill or neutralize by contact. Systemic treatments are absorbed and translocated internally to protect against pests and pathogens without the need for direct contact during application. EMPRO and Ewing sprayers come with 3 flat fan nozzles designed for specific applications. Flat fan nozzles, in general, are good for broadcast applications in larger areas. They're designed to work best when held in a fixed position and at a consistent height from the ground, which is based on pattern width and desired overlap. The brown nozzle emits liquids at an 80-degree angle and at a volume of 0.57 gallons per minute at 20 psi, which is common for pump-type sprayer pressure. The battery sprayers operate at 40 psi, where the output for the brown tip will be 0.8 gallons per minute. This is ideal for larger areas or broadcast applications. It will also be better suited for soil-applied materials such as pre-emergent herbicides, systemic fungicides and insecticides, and soil-applied fertilizers. The red nozzle discharges liquids at a 70-degree angle with a flow rate of 0.25 gallons per minute at 20 psi and 0.31 gallons per minute at 40 psi. This lower volume of output may be a better option for materials that perform best when left on the leaf surface, such as post-emergent herbicides and contact fungicides, or operations like bowl sprays of insecticides on trees or structural perimeter insecticide applications. The yellow nozzle applies materials at a 35-degree angle and flow rate of 0.15 gallons per minute at 20 psi and 0.31 gallons per minute at 40 psi, which is the narrowest and lowest volume of all 3 flat fan nozzles. This is ideal for precision applications such as weed management between plants, where it is critical for the spray to not make contact with desirable landscaping plants. It will also be a good choice for non-selective herbicide applications on fence lines or around structures. If you need to hit a target, like a hornet's nest, from a distance, or for crack and crevice pest control applications, an orange jet stream nozzle is also included with the EMPRO and Ewing sprayers. It produces a concentrated, long-range stream with a flow rate of 0.35 gallons per minute at 20 psi and 0.5 gallons per minute at 40 psi. The most versatile nozzle in the kit is the adjustable brass nozzle. This nozzle can be modified to deliver either a solid stream or a hollow cone spray pattern. This tip is ideal for targeted herbicide applications in landscape beds or along driveways or walkways. It is also good for brush control and edging buildings and fences. It may not be the best for broadcast lawn applications, as the spray pattern may be inconsistent. Finally, the foaming tip in the kit has a nominal flow rate and creates a thick foam that makes it easier to identify areas that have already been treated. Foaming nozzles are especially helpful when making applications to vertical surfaces where runoff might be a concern. Remember to calibrate your sprayer in advance to ensure you're meeting the application requirements for the chemical that you're using. A link to our video on how to do that can be found in the description. Also, consider mixing in a spray pattern dye indicator. This will make it easier to identify areas that have already been sprayed, helping to reduce overspray and misses. As always, it is best to only mix what you plan to apply for the day. When you're done for the day, be sure to empty and clean the spray tank with an approved cleaner, paying special attention to filters and screens. Also, never use a sprayer that has had herbicides in it for other plant protectant applications. Finally, always read and fully understand the chemical label that you intend to use and wear the proper personal protective equipment when mixing and spraying. For more information on pump sprayers and other landscape and irrigation products, stop into your local Ewing branch or visit us online at ewingoutdoorsupply.com.